Hi, it's Dani and I'm back with another Ida video for you guys. This is the second of the three videos that I'm gonna release for the How to Edit Like Ida series. In the first video, we did a very warm and vibrant summery look, but the style that we're gonna try to achieve today is more muted and cold and moody. And I'm going to be using her photos of her recent trip to Amsterdam as the basis for this look. I gave a more detailed art direction explanation of Ida and how she styles her feet in the first video. If you haven't seen it yet, I highly suggest you watch it. But to summarize, the most important thing to remember is to post and take photos of things that contribute to the look that you're going for. I said this in the last video, but I want to emphasize that your feet is only as good as each of the photos that you post. So for example, in the last video, we were trying to achieve a colorful look, meaning the things that we should be taking photos of are colorful scenes. But for this style, the vibe is very city. We see lots of buildings and architecture here. So I suggest shooting in similar places too if you want to achieve this aesthetic. Obviously, we're not going to find buildings like these in the Philippines, but you can try taking photos in front of light-colored buildings or scenery. And I say light-colored specifically because we want to get a lot of creams and purple tones. So if you shoot in front of, let's say, a red or an orange building, you're probably not going to achieve the same aesthetic. Clothing-wise, Ida mainly wears solid neutrals, not a lot of prints. So if you want a similar look, you'll have to wear more of khakis, greens, blacks, whites. Not much of other colors. So for example, if Ida wore a floral dress or a red dress, it wouldn't have given the same vibe. I'm just using Ida's feet as a basis for this look. But at the end of the day, whatever you want to do is completely up to you. It's all up to your style and how you want to present yourself. Before we get to the editing part, don't forget to follow me on Instagram. My handle is @DanielleOlan. Comment down below or DM me if you have any suggestions on what look you want me to do next, and I'll try my best to recreate it. Now, the photos I'm going to be editing are those that I took during my trip to Europe last summer. Coincidentally, they were also taken in Amsterdam, so it's good because at least it gives a similar vibe. As I mentioned in the last video, I'll also be selling presets for this look. You can get them if you want, so you don't have to make this look completely from scratch. The link is in the description box. You can get them now, or if you want to wait for the Ida collection, which will contain all the three Ida-inspired presets, I'll release everything after my three How to Edit Like Ida videos. So if you want a simple and hassle-free way to achieve this look, feel free to buy them, but I'm still going to teach you how to edit this from scratch, and you can customize this to your own style too if you want. Remember that we're not gonna get the exact same look because we're using different photos, but we're gonna try to get as close as we can. This is the first photo we're gonna edit. First, we're gonna go to the light section and we're gonna click on curves. So we're gonna adjust the highlights and the shadows to something like this. And then adjust the reds. And then the greens. And then we'll adjust the blues to this. The curves tool is actually the trickiest part of Lightroom. This is how you really get your colors, but it's also the most difficult because it's all trial and error. You're not gonna get exactly the same settings even when you try to copy it, but all it takes is a bit of patience and practice, and eventually you'll come up with something good. Next, we're gonna go to the light section. We're gonna increase the exposure, lower the contrast, put the highlights down all the way, increase the shadows, drag the whites down all the way too, and increase the black so there's not a lot of shadows around. Next, we go to the color tool. We're gonna increase the temperature just a little bit so that you can still get a warm color or a warm look even with all the purple tones. And then how we're gonna get the purple tones is to increase the tint just a bit, and we'll decrease the vibrance by 5, okay? Now we go to mix. Mix is where you can isolate each color setting. So for red, because I'm wearing a red jacket, let's make it more red, less saturated. And I want my jacket to kind of be darker. We'll drag the luminance down. Next, for orange, adjust the tint. Make my skin less saturated. And drag the luminance button down a bit. Now for yellow, we're just gonna drag the saturation a bit down. And the luminance a bit down. For greens, we'll move the hue up. Saturation down. And luminance button down. Next, for aqua, move the tint just a bit, saturation down. Lastly, for blue, we're just gonna drag the saturation button down so the sky's not too saturated, and the luminance button down too. We're not gonna edit purples and pinks because you don't really see purples and pinks in this photo. Now we go to split toning. This is where you can pick the color that you want for your highlights and shadows. I want to get more purple tones as highlights, so we're gonna add a bit of purple highlight. Okay, and then we press done. Now what we're gonna do is copy the setting, and then we're gonna paste it to my next photo. For this photo, it's not very saturated. We're just gonna go to color, mix, adjust the blues to make it more saturated, darker, and let's adjust the tint. Go to orange, increase the saturation just a bit, just to give more color to my face. Maybe increase the saturation of the red too, just a bit. And we'll decrease the tint because I feel like it's too purpley. Okay, and press done. Okay, next photo. I wanna increase the saturation of my skin just a bit too. And maybe the blues will make it more saturated. Done. Okay, last photo. I think I wanna make this photo more vibrant, kinda dead the colors. Next, go to mix. Make the red more saturated. Adjust the hue of the orange just a bit. Maybe increase the exposure just a bit. Done. Now we're gonna try the preset on Ida's photo. This is an unedited photo of Ida that I found on Twitter. Okay, it looks good so far. Maybe we can adjust the exposure just a bit. Increase the vibrance. And increase the tint a bit. Maybe make the highlights more purple, so that's what split toning's for. And we're good. Now I'm gonna show you before and afters of all the four photos that I edited. And then we're gonna compare my feed to Ida's. Again, if you don't wanna bother with all these steps and you want an easy and hassle-free way to achieve this look, my presets are for sale. You can get an Ida-inspired feed in 5 minutes. Like I said in the last video, there's no solid formula for this. You kind of have to work with what you have and adjust the setting per photo. If you want a lot of creams and purple tones, then you'll need to shoot things that have more light colors, especially whites. For this part of the feed in particular, you'll notice that Ida has a lot of buildings as filler photos, which contribute to both the feel of the feed and the color palette. So if you want a similar look, then I suggest that you post more buildings or more photos of yourself in front of buildings too. I gave a more detailed explanation as to how to plan your feed in the last video, but some apps that you can use are Unum, Preview, and Plan. They're all free apps. All you have to do is drag the photos around to see what order they look best in, and you'll get a concrete idea of how your feed's gonna look like. And that's how it's done. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!